Took us over 30 minutes to get here, but we're finally here. It is the Dota 2 Canada Cup Season 4. For whatever reason, Valve decided to just have the server shit out on us. But you know what? That's not different than any other day of the week. So hopefully we can get this entire best of three done and underway. Of course, this best of three, a big one. The quarterfinals still going on. Champions of Summoners, or Summer's Rift, I guess.
It's Summoners.
It's supposed to be Summoners. Why they spell it Summer? You know what? Listen, I'm not going to.
It's Jimmy, dude.
We're not going to get into it. It's actually X-Fire. By X-Fire, I mean it's like Brax, Mad, and Demon versus Union Gaming here. A best of three series now getting underway. Again, I'm joined today, as always, by MottPax, our stats man, who we love and adore furiously, as well as my great co-caster, Greg, who, you know, listen, why did you decide to start Gurg Live when Canada Cup was going on? Can you just
because I hate
questions?
You, Travis.
Yeah, exactly.
Because you're too big for High Ground TV. I was trying to push you out of the organization.
Exactly.
That's the truth.
You heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen. Unbelievable. How are you, man?
I'm doing good. You know, this game, I thought it was literally never going to start. And now we made it.
At least it's
we made
not the
it.
Other
We're
day.
Here.
At least it's not the other day where we had Your Beast that's just started. We had to wait literally like 2 hours to get one game of Dota played. So that was great. That was good stuff.
Well, somehow we made it through the entire draft without mentioning anything about it.
That's good.
And Fetchel Spirit, Viper, Skywrath, and Sniper banned out for X-Fire. We're going to call him X-Fire. I like that better than Champion of Summer's Rift. And
why
for
X-Fire?
Union Gaming, Batrider, Lycan, Medusa, and Queen of Pain.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Union Gaming, they pick up the Templar Assassin for Blank slash Sora slash whatever you want to call him. The person that has no name currently in the game playing the Templar Assassin, that's probably his favorite hero. And it's a hero they pick up a lot, and he does work with it. They even pulled him a bottle last time I saw them pick this hero. They literally pulled him a bottle. So that's something.
Like a whole... Wait.
So, okay, Trident Protector was one of their picks.
They literally pulled him a bottle?
Trident Protector was one of their picks. They waited like... I guess a minute after the game started, then bought him a bottle. Actually, I think he got a CS, then bought the bottle, and then gave it to the TA. It was something
hilarious.
Else. Actually, they might have given him a bounty rune. I'm not sure. Yeah, it's pretty funny.
That's impressive. And Clockwork Juggernaut, TA, and Disruptor for Union Gaming. I like this lineup. I like TA. I feel like TA is underutilized.
She's got her moments. She has her matchups. She's pretty good. I like her matchup against Shadow Fiend. Against Sniper is iffy, but still kind of okay.
She's pretty good against this matchup.
Against the Troll or Zeus?
I mean,
who knows?
Either, I think, is pretty
fun. Yeah, she's pretty good against those matchups. Like, against Troll.
Although, one thing I don't know is Whirling Axes. Is that one instance of damage?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
That's pretty good, then. Yeah, I like this.
I'm pretty sure it's not. I'm pretty sure you
get
hit by
one. The spinning one you just get hit once, right? And then it doesn't hit you again.
Yeah, exactly. Because then it just takes that giant chunk of life out of your HP pool. And you're like, I guess I'm dead already.
I like this so far, then. I mean, there's really nothing that gets rid of Refraction easily here.
Yeah.
Still get called, which is annoying, but whatever.
I think she might have a good sign this game. They need some sort of multiple damage instance ability, and they just don't have it right now. And they go for the Enigma as well, so all of a sudden their lane setup looks like they might have a bit of an advantage here in the laning phase because of this Enigma, assuming his jungle doesn't get warded and he has generally a good time. So I think this is a solid choice for Union Gaming. PE, which I'm sure stands for Peru. Then... X-Fire. Why did you call them that, by the way? They'll be picking up their last hero.
X-Fire, like X-Fire. Like used to be fire.
Oh, I was like...
Sort of like ex-girlfriend.
I thought you were talking about the sponsor
Except
of the tournament.
X-Fire? No, I'm not that much... Well, actually, that was completely coincidental. Now I look like a huge sellout, but... you know, it was like X-Gosu. I just like that. X-I-Buy-Power in CSGO. I like it. Better than this garbage name.
Oh, you know what just happened? I bit my tongue earlier on in the afternoon. It was miserable. And I just bit my lip. And it's really just, it's not my day today, honestly. I don't know what's happening. Jesus.
Rough life. Well, Dazzle's the last pick here. That's something, I guess. That will help them a little bit.
They don't have anything really to deal with the TA. And I guess not even the Juggernaut either. They could try to burst him down before he gets his Blade Fury off. Now, these two cores for Union Gaming might do some work here in this game. Honestly, it's in the realm of possibility, but Zeus versus TA matchup, not the best matchup in the world for Zeus. Psyblade damage. He has to sit pretty far back in order to not just get decimated by her, which is kind of tough. So we'll see how things turn out. I don't know why. They have the house. Prepare like for they're all about house for whatever reason. I have no idea why. It's interesting. Anyway.
I mean, who doesn't like House, man?
I mean, I think it's a good show, but
I like it. But they do. Wow, that's a lot of house. You got
yeah, they really out. Went in on this house stuff.
Really bizarre.
I mean, all right, I guess. Good work. Good work, team. X-Fire.
Man, well, quick introductions here. Demon Online, Brax on Zeus. Banana Slam Jamma, the new hype streamer. It's me on the troll. Super Bugatti hype. 420, a.k.a. Miracle Chipmunk on the Axe. And fucking Mad on the Dazzle.
Nice. All right, that's the Dire team. The Radiant team, Union Gaming, Ben Haas playing your Juggernaut, who was approximately 30 minutes late to the match for... I guess it wasn't his fault, but... goddamn if I don't blame somebody. Nightmare playing the Disruptor, the stand-in. I actually haven't seen this guy play before. Z-Talk on your Enigma. Blank or Sora playing your Templar Assassin. Greedy playing your Clockwork. Greedy. And, all right,
great
well,
name.
He is,
looks like there's gonna be some contest here over these this top rune. Seems this is the, always the rune that's contested.
The top rune?
Yeah.
I guess well, so.
Clockwork just gave him the good old Dunkerino.
That is not the way to start the match if you are a Summoner's Rift. They lost both. Oh, no, wait, they got bottom rune. They got
bottom rune, yeah.
They're going for the aggro dual lane with the Axe Dazzle. That seems pretty miserable to deal with. You're in this Trilander dual lane for the Radiant team, which so far is a dual lane. Ascend Enigma top for the time being, but his jungle is not warded, so that's interesting and almost unnecessary. Yeah, he's definitely going to jungle in the aggressive in the aggressive lane. Don't block that camp, man. All right, you're in. No, he blocked his own. He just blocked that camp.
Whoopsie.
What? How
there
did
is one
that,
ward
dude?
Here. There's one ward, but jungle
right,
was pretty much fine
camp.
For taking.
That's the only camp that's blocked is that camp.
Yeah, I mean, he definitely could have just jungled here. It would have been fine.
Why did he block his own camp? Oh, that bothers me so much.
You know, Travis, you're going to have to ask him.
I don't speak Spanish. That's the problem.
Well, taking a quick look at CS here, it appears that the very, very early laning stage is not working out for Union Gaming as they are already struggling. And if this does not turn around quickly, they could be in some deep trouble.
It's like the first creep wave, though. It's fine, I think. Although
mostly
this is a really tough
Zeus
lane for
TA.
This is a really tough lane for the Juggernaut. Like, he's gonna get run at a lot, and it's not gonna be fun. And I feel like the Disruptor is. Oh my god! What just? Oh, he's sniped. That's why he went in the aggro jungle. It's all worth it. But good job, Z-Talk. Nicely done.
Well, that I think this lane's gonna be a good old stomp in favor of the TA now. Not sure how Brax is supposed to function in this lane without a bottle.
He didn't get it to him. If he had gotten the bottle before...
If he had gotten the bottle, this would have been fine, but...
Yeah.
Since he didn't, that is...
That's pretty miserable.
Not good, as they say.
And so now it makes him look like a genius, this Enigma, which I was concerned.
Oh, Demon is going for the snipe!
He's going for it as well. Is he going to get it?
Oh, this is going to be... Oh,
no.
Run, little piggy!
Get it, Demon! He's got the boots, the piggy doesn't! The courier, he's...
Oh, he's going to get it.
He really thought about diving that tower for a second. It's right here in the trees.
I mean, at this point, though, getting this courier kill doesn't matter nearly as much. He got the bottle.
Oh, he's going to get it. Oh! All right, nice. Has been both couriers dead.
I mean,
Karn's already
fine,
in the
right?
lane.
But it's not like, it's not nearly as impactful as Brax losing his courier.
No, definitely not. I mean,
so, especially because TA with Psyblades can knock down the creep wave pretty efficiently if you really make a concerted effort to do that and can just make it to the rune easily. We're going to get the top regeneration rune here, unless Jimmy uses both stuns.
He might. Find the hex. Yep, he will. Meanwhile, the first blood bottom as Bugatti walks right underneath the towers, too busy looking at the top rune spot. Off to a good start for us casters here. Yeah, Bugatti gets the kill, throws up the call, Berserker's call, and he just dives the tower onto the Disruptor, and already he's just cutting the... He's got 1,000 gold. He's rich. Oh my god, that's a problem.
Yeah, I think this lane's going to be really hard.
They're
I
winning
mean,
all three lanes? Yeah, they're winning all three lanes.
Well, Bugatti's
Bugatti
actually potentially
going to
take some damage
here.
No levels in Grave!
Nope. He's going to avoid the Blade Fury. He might live. He has Call. He has Battle Hunger for that extra speed boost.
My.
He's going to salve up. He might even turn on Ben Haas. Ben Haas is like, I can't get in range. Bugatti walks back. He's looking for Nightmare.
Oh, Nightmare is one click from dying.
But they're going to go on Benhaz instead. Berserker's call. It's going to go. They'll get the kill. That's a huge pickup. The Eidolon's dead. Z-Talk can't do anything. Oh, man. This bottom lane couldn't go any worse.
And Nightmare almost died there, too. He has to go back to the fountain, which at this point, at level 2, might be even worse because he has to walk all the way down and then either spend 100 gold, which at this point is pretty precious, or walk all the way back. Either way.
If he buys that TP scroll, I'm going to be a bit upset. If he walks back, fine. Like that, you lose out on a lot of experience, but that 100 gold, man. You need money, I guess. He's not really pulling either. He can't pull because they're just pushing his creep wave.
So either way, you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't. He has to sit on the juggernaut because if he leaves at all, then you know what was happening to him is just going to happen to Benhaz. Benhaz does have spin, which helps, but obviously call is a thing that he has to deal with.
Yo, Bugatti's like, I'm having such a good lane. I'm going to go for an early Vanguard. Ring of Health. He pretty much has his Vanguard if he gets like 3 or 4 more creeps or something. It's ridiculous. Obviously, he needs to stat shield as well.
He's off to a very, very, very good start here. But what's going right here for Union Gaming? The mid lane. Brax is actually doing very, very well. He's gotten now his bottle back and has managed to keep up in CS. That's actually really, really impressive. And extremely important because if mid lane had just been a disaster, Zeus would have been behind on mobility items. And especially when you're facing up against a hero like TA, if you don't have a mobility item on Zeus, you are going to get shredded by that hero.
It's a 5-minute Vanguard. And now they rotated.
There's going to be some heavy dives now, I expect.
I don't know how you kill Bugatti anymore. I don't think you can with these two heroes. Thunderstrike does okay damage, but it's level 1 still.
Yeah, no, I mean, they can't do anything.
Mad's going to walk in. They actually saw
Dazzle
that ward.
Dazzle is fearless.
Nightmare has
Dazzle is level 4.
Ward. He doesn't have Grave yet. Does he have a skill point being saved? Yeah, he does. So, all right, this tower is going to fall within maybe 2 to 3 minutes. And I don't know. Benhaz is like, help? Where do I go, team? I can't go bottom. That's not safe. Where do I farm? Radiant's bottom tower. Maybe you go top, but even that.
Hard.
I mean, you can't really farm against a troll. That's not really a good matchup.
He's underleveled, underfarmed.
He's going to get battle phase. Yeah.
Yeah, he'll get destroyed if he goes up there. I don't really know what he's supposed to do. Jungle?
I guess the lane is safer once they take down the tier 1 tower. But even then, like, you can only farm a bit. So he has the Vanguard done. He's getting a Blink Dagger. Rotation to the top rune spot. Z-Tox should rotate up top. They'll try to put pressure on the troll who's getting absolute free farm.
So Benhaz is going to move into the Dire Jungle and take a stack here. That's something.
That's
an effective view. Better than what he was doing at
least. Yeah, exactly.
I mean, he's getting more farm, more experience than he would be getting in the bottom lane. And that's all you can really ask for. Level 6 for Zeus, so Thunder God's Wrath now available. Banana Slam Jamma has 43 CS, 44 CS. This guy appears to know how to hit creeps.
He is a creep hit, although it's pretty easy when you have Coin Blade on a True Warlord.
Yeah.
That is.
He looks like he's just going for a very standard build here. Phase, Coin Blade, Blads.
Yeah, I mean, once you get that Morbid Mask, you're set. You get the SNY next for BKB. I think SNY is probably the better option this game. Yeah, I think there's no real need to get a BKB this game. I don't think anyway. At least not yet. If he wants to, you can get it later. Mid lane, Brax might get jumped on. Meld Strike. Brax does have a regen rune, but he's dead. He popped the regen rune, but there's the Hex onto Sora. Earth Spike is gonna go. Mad rotated in, but it's hookshot misses. It splits between the two supports. Sora back up, and he was like, "I'm trying to fight on this," but the Clockwork Hook missed. Now Bugatti runs in, has Coin Blade. He's gonna chop him down. That Berserker's Call going to work. Bugatti getting that huge kill. Gets up to 1,800 gold at 7.5 minutes. He's probably going to have a Vanguard Blink at 9, maybe even 8.
I think those cogs from Greedy right there definitely saved him, though. It knocked the Axe down really low in mana, gave him an escape path, so good use there of cogs able to make it out of this one. He has a bottle of his own.
That is something. Oh, man. Brax rotates back in, so he dies, but they get the return kill. Berserker's Call onto a couple of Eidolons. See you later. He has money for his Blink Dagger. Bugatti.
Wow, this is a lot of farm. Like,
yeah,
that is impressive.
It's boots, 8 minutes. And treads, it's only 8 minutes, and this troll has 63 CS. Blink. And also, he has Boots Vanguard Blink at fastest Vanguard Blink Dagger base, 6.83 by 2 minutes. I mean, if it wasn't, I would be a little upset.
If it wasn't, I would be surprised. That is extremely impressive.
I don't know who farms that faster.
I mean, like, this is, what are the ramifications? I mean, he can basically do whatever he wants for the next, like, couple of minutes. Like, you what is a juggernaut going to do to him?
You can't kill him.
What is a disruptor going to do?
Black hole, Omni Slash, maybe TA right click, and then you can kill him if you're lucky, I think. But if
I mean, if there's any sort of reasonable engagement, this axe is just going to stomp on people.
If the onus is on you and Gimme to not get caught by like a three-man Berserker's Call, because if they do, they're just going to lose the game, I think.
This axe can potentially just break the game open, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Fastest all time, or two. Again, you know what? I was going to say this, but like, how is that not the fastest of all time? That was impressive down bottom. But you have that kind of dual lane against a dual lane that is very, very soft and weak. And you're supposed to crush it. And not only he crushes it, but he gets so much out of it as well.
He takes so much farm away from the Juggernaut, who's sitting on literally treads. That's it. And a wand. That is pretty sad. On the bright side here, though, Enigma is almost done with his mechanism. So fairly good timing. Maybe the mechanism gives him some game against this axe. Clockwork is level 6. He's found some decent experience.
Well, the thing is that Enigma is level 6 at 9.5 minutes into the game. Level 6 usually happens at 4.5 minutes for good Enigmas or Enigmas with free farm.
Uh-oh, Bugatti though.
That might be enough. He was low health. Bugatti does have Berserker's Call. He'll use it, but
he's
in trouble.
He's fucking mad, I guess, here.
They get the Zeus ult. Bugatti's going to live the Vanguard, paying for itself. Thunderstruck is going to get healed up. Finger of Death. Goodbye, Enigma. Nightmare getting caught out as well. Ben Haas, he does have Omni Slash. He'll get Demon. He'll leave. TP. That was the shout button. Anyways, they're going to chase it up to Ben Haas. It's a 2-for-1 trade. Poison Sing, Poison Touch, whatever. And Ben Haas is going to get his Blade Fury going. He'll be able to walk away, probably. All right. I mean, I guess they get Demon out of it, but
that was like half a second away from being way worse, though.
Yeah.
They almost had a stick on Zeus, which would have given him another Lightning Bolt, and that would have been a problem.
Banana Slam Jamma walking away from that top tier Wind Tower, which has been assaulted, but is actually okay. Survive. Brax has 1,400. Gold in the bank. Drum Charge popped. Mad's going to throw up the Poison Touch. Backs away. They're going to pop up the Lightning Bolt. Throw a Central Ward on the ground as well to make sure that no Melt Strike is going to come in.
Yeah, and probably unsurprisingly, the Troll's actually gone for an Aquila instead of finishing the Vlads. And that gives him a pretty solid amount of damage. I mean, sitting for 134. That's pretty good for 11 minutes into the game. Very, very efficient item, Aquila, for damage. Gives you 18 damage. It's pretty deceiving if you're an agility hero.
He's hitting hard. He's a Yasha now. That is some damage going the way of the Troll Warlord. Bugatti's clearing up an Aegis deck also. And he's, like Mount Pack said, the third richest axe at 10 minutes ever. And something else.
Yeah, Union Gaming here. I mean, the Juggernaut is stunted. And usually in the mid game, he gives you a lot of power with that Omni Slash, but this game, that's definitely not going to be the case. He's just way behind in items. Thunder God's Wrath used just to see exactly what's going on right here. And I think, the Axe is going to go for an engagement. And I mean, he can just farm. He can get picks. He can do whatever he wants, honestly.
What do you get next now? Like, I guess, like, Force, maybe? Ags, if you're feeling...
Force, Blade Mail is probably reasonable. Maybe.
Yeah, Blade Mail seems pretty good against a TA.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Maybe that's not where he wants to go. He might just go for a larger item, but I mean, when he has a Vanguard like this, they might just choose to try to ignore him, in which case the Blade Mail wouldn't be very good.
I think Ags then is probably the choice. The average Zeus ult hits 4.4 enemy heroes. Really? something
well.
Smoking the seeds or something. I don't know, man. That's a weird stat. Yeah, I guess dead people as well. Smokes dead people. You know how it is.
He is working towards Yasha as well. So TA is getting some farm here. With the phase Yasha build, I mean, this is pretty standard TA build that we've seen recently. The BKB has to be very, very soon on the, I think, on the list of shopping items, though, for the TA. Going up against a Lion. And a Zeus. I mean, if you don't have refraction and Zeus is like near you at all, you are just dead instantly.
I think you go for the casual Yasha and then you get the BKB. That seems to be the
case. Yeah, I mean, I think you kind of have to get. I mean, especially given how far behind they are, right? I mean, if Summoner's Rift just decided to push right now or in like the next couple of minutes, PA will potentially just get like rolled on, because you can take away the refraction charges with Dazzle during call, and or anything during call really, and then you're just screwed. So I don't know. I think a BKB might be worth the investment. So you're a little bit more tanky. Obviously, you don't have to deal with Alliance EC.
I'm surprised, honestly, that Radiant's middle tower is under attack. They're not pushing a bit harder than maybe.
Yeah, I would like to see X Fire be more aggressive here. Well, they're gonna go for Roshan.
I mean, they have
that certainly counts. He has a Saj and Yasha. Banana Slam Jam has 136 CS.
At 13 and a half minutes, actually 14 minutes, still pretty freaking impressive. That's something else. He spent a lot of time in the jungle in that top lane, and it's paying off. He's going to get a free Roshan. They take this down so quickly. And the classic tier 1 tower trade for Rosh is occurring. Meanwhile, they're going to TP to the mid lane. They might get there in time. Banana Slam Jamma can't quite finish this up. Now they'll pop the Zeus ult. Omni Slash, but now there's the Grave coming out of the desk. Can't even get one kill. Poison Touch. Banana Slam Jamma gets the Aegis. They're going to try to back away. Banana Slam Jamma wants to fight. Blink call on to two. Static Storm goes in. Does nothing in the process. They'll lose two heroes quickly. There's going to be the Air Spike. Finger going onto the clockwork. Three down. They only lose the Dazzle. Brax on the run. Meanwhile, there's going to be a glimpse back in. Nightmare trying to get out. TA in some trouble. Arc Lightning. Refraction up in a second. Doesn't matter. Berserker's call. Slam. They get the kill. Banana Slam Jamma not going to lose the Aegis. Taking a lot of tower hits. Oh, he will lose it. They did not take the aggro off. Aegis goes down, but they win the fight 4-1. Whew. What a fight.
Yeah, you know, I was just thinking about, you know, how did Union Gaming actually end up in this position where they're, like, not losing the game at 13, 15 minutes, but they're at such a heavy deficit right now that the game looks very, very, very bad. I mean, they're down almost 10k gold already. And I think a lot of it comes down to the Disruptor support. Disruptor's so bad in lane. I mean, the only thing he's good at, really, is zoning offlaners because Thunderstrike is, like, decent, and he has an okay attack animation to get, like, a couple right-clicks off on offlaners. Mm. When you get dual-land like that and just get crushed, the hero's just completely useless. I mean, just the Static Storm was just did nothing because all the heroes have so much HP that they can just stand through it, right-click through it,
yeah, they
and then when it's over,
damage.
Walk out and kill everyone.
Yeah, they took no damage from that.
It looks like Bugatti's actually going to go for an AC, and I like that quite a bit. When you think about the troll, the battle trance, the reduction in armor is going to be extra effective with that. And Banana Slam Jamma has picked up a Helm of the Dominator, has gotten a wolf following him around as well. And still farming
being
away.
For Warlord at 60 minutes in on a winning team. That's pretty nice.
I mean, he had like 15 minutes to do whatever he wanted, got a Roshan, got a really good team fight, and now he's just going to be off to the races.
Demon
here.
Has a Blink Dagger, by the way.
That's
incredible.
He had it at 15
minutes. He actually got it after that fight, within like seconds after that fight.
Wow, Banana, that's actually unreal. Banana's the second richest troll, 15, Bugatti's the third. Well, Clockwork gonna move in a Brax in the mid lane. Zeus, this is the weakness. He does have a Yule, it's gonna help him out for a little bit. Buys a TP, still gonna be falling in the end. Fucking Matt, a little bit too late on the rotation, but follow a fight, Bugatti. Gets a call, Demon comes in, there's a black hole and three heroes though! Is this even gonna be enough? Bugatti's so tanky! He gets Shallow Grave, he's gonna walk away, they're gonna lose fucking mad. But this could have been worse. Omni Slash used Bugatti falls.
Wow, Z-talk.
It takes all of their abilities to kill a couple heroes. Meanwhile,
yeah, they do kill him. They get a big fight. That's a huge fight going the way. But meanwhile, Banana Slam Jamma working on the tier 2 tower. He's gonna back away from that top lane. Forces out a couple rotations. Oh, Demon cancels the TP from Z-Talk, but where's the follow-up? Gets an Earth Spike off, but doesn't have Finger to kill Z-Talk, so...
He had Finger in like 1 second. So sad. You see those tight timings? Like, man, one more second, he would have killed him.
That was a huge fight for Union Gaming. They got a couple thousand gold. Yep. Yeah, I saw that. They could have gotten three heroes instead, or four heroes, instead they got three. Demon getting Glimpse back up top. That might have been a mistake, a bit of a miscommunication, but that's all right. Huge black hole coming out from Z-Talk, though. And they walked right back into it.
Yeah, I mean, getting the cores is really all you can ask for. Clockwork goes for Blade Mail here, which I like quite a bit. I feel like this item has gotten a lot more popular again than Clockwork. I feel
it's
like for a while.
Game, yeah.
Yeah, I feel like for a while, like, you know, a couple months ago, it was not as popular, and now you basically get it every game. When you're behind against Zeus, it's pretty good as well. Good against Lion, obviously. I like this quite a bit.
I'm definitely good a fan. Stuff.
Yeah.
I'm a fan of the item. Demon walking back towards the bottom lane. a bit flustered maybe that his team just lost a huge fight, but still, they're probably not that concerned. Banana Slim Jim wasn't anywhere near the engagement. He is super farmed. Bugatti is going to have an Assault Kuraz probably within 3 minutes, I'd say. He already has 2,000. He could buy his plate mail now.
He should.
Or he might go Mjolnir. Axe Mjolnir is something we don't see that often, but it's still a thing because of the static shield.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's semi-reasonable, I would say. It's decent against the TA as well, so extra things to take off for Fraction.
Yeah.
I'm thinking about this, and I think if Fire lose this game, it's going to come down to that Axe buying Vanguard Blink Dagger and then farming for a couple minutes. They've still gotten a lot out of this game, and he's still really farmed, so it might be worth it in the end. But they might wish they'd put a little bit more aggression onto a couple heroes when they had that huge advantage. He might be dead here.
He should be. He's taking a lot of damage. He's going to live.
Oh, he is so speedy.
Yeah, they can't catch him. TP from Benha still actually get out. So he does escape in time. Still, big though, the kill stays there. Alive. Braxton bottom is alone, by the way.
Union Gaming is just buying time for Benhaz right now. And, I mean, it's working. He's farming. He's still way under farm comparatively.
Yeah.
But it's going. And he is going for Desolator. A very aggressive item build.
Well, he wants to do before he gets to PKB, which is fine.
Yeah, I mean, I can understand that.
There's a strumming out.
He seems to not really have too many problems right now.
Berserker's call is going to go. They're going to find Z-Tuck. Whoa. They finger him? I don't know if that's necessary. They get the kill anyway, but there was an Enigma there. Not anymore. Benhaz is like, I want to Omni-Slash you. Bugatti's like, all right, I'm going to Berserker's call. Good luck killing me. Glimps back in onto Bugatti, by the way. They're going to try to fight and kill him. He might die now. He should die. Almost gets the Culling Blade off on Benhaz. Meanwhile, Demon gets caught out. Gets pushed out of the cogs. Earthspike's going to go. Demon has Blink in 5. He'll just walk away. Cogs. He should be fine, I think. But they lose Bugatti.
I wish Fire had a mech. I don't know who would get it, but I wish they had a mech.
Yeah, this is not a mech.
I feel like they'd just be crushing this game if there was a mech. Or if fucking Matt was in that fight. Like, it would have gone a lot better for them, but
yeah,
he doesn't even have that much healing. I mean, he has 4 levels in Poison Touch, 3 levels in Grave. That only is one level.
That's a super interesting skill build.
In Shadow Wave. Yeah. I mean, he's been forced to do a lot of, or at least attempt to make a lot of long rotations, and quite often, although I don't think any of them have really worked out, but I think that's probably why he's doing it.
Well, I mean, this game probably could have been over by now had they put pressure on him.
Honestly, this game could have been over
if they'd taken fights that they were supposed to take.
I mean, look at this. I mean, they were down 10k, now they're almost up to 5k. So
hey, you gave me a play this very well. This game is certainly not out of reach for the Peruvian squad, but they have a lot more work to do. But Summoner's Rift, they should have had this game by the balls, and they kind of just let it go. Also, you can give me played very well, which is a part of the reason why they're still somewhat in this game. Although they have to deal with a super farm troll warlord who's going to be having Scotty pretty soon. They have to deal with an Axe at this point who's almost got... It is an Assault Kuraz, so your first instincts were correct. And his Scotty... Banana Slam Jamma is one ultimate orb away from his Scotty, which is not very far. So I think you get that Scotty and you fight. They'll see Benhaz here. He's going to walk right into him. Light Fury's going to go. No Bash coming out. Kinetic Field, Static Storm, Benhaz.
Slam Jamma.
We'll see you later. Omni Slash.
Oh, he actually flips him out of the Omni Slash.
Why? He got scared. He had to glimpse him out. But meanwhile, there's going to be the TA running in, has the Desolator Melt Strike. Banana Slam Jamma gets the Grave off Mad, going to try to save his teammate's life. Is he going to try to fight this? Axe is walking in. Call only gets onto one, I believe. Earthspike onto two. There's the jam. They hex up Z-Talk, who is looking for the hole. Now he's going to actually mana drain him, and he has his Soaring, but not enough mana to get his black hole off. Demon probably falls here, but you can fight into this, I think, now. If you are Summoner's Rift, they decide against it, though. They're going to back away. Big trade coming up for Union Gaming. That should have been a lot worse for them again.
Honestly, like, what is this Disruptor doing? Just glimpsing people out of ultimates.
What is TA
and stuff?
Doing? Bugatti looking for a blink. He's gonna find it.
This does not look great.
Counter Helix Prox not quite there. They could jam him. Yeah, they will. All right, Bugatti gets the kill even with.
He jams it in.
His right clicks are ridiculous. They have an Assault Kuraz. The amount of damage he takes off per hit is ridiculous. For an Axe, even has a lot of damage. Only 100, but Z-Talk has got a blink into the trees. Weave is on cooldown. That's the problem. Brax does have lightning, but he has no mana for it. Yep, they see him. They know he's there, though. Brax doesn't have mana for lightning, but Weave catches the edge of it.
Not sure he's going to make it out of this one.
He didn't.
He jams it in. I'm going to say that every time he gets a dunk. You fought
badly. We need that announcer pack, man.
The good one. Well, Scotty's completed at 23 minutes, and that one might not be a record, but this is certainly an impressive timing for the troll.
And how do you deal with him? 2.4k? Oh my god, Nobusada, please. Buddy, please.
I mean, honestly, I think the bigger thing is, like, is the HP, right? I mean, they have a Desolator with the minus armor, but 2400 HP is quite a bit. They have good CC to deal with this TA since the BKB is not completed yet. Demon, I mean, if Demon gets, like, you know, one CC spell off in this TA, then I think without Refraction, then it should be pretty easy for them to bring them down. Even if it does have Refraction on, they have, you know, Axe Call. I mean, really, that's the main source of damage. Like, Clockwork, going to go in.
Oh, that Yule Scepter, that came out from Brax, stops him from picking up the Aegis. Static Storm hits on literally no one. Demon's going to get Grave. They're going to get the call off. They're going to blow up that poor troll. Banana Slam, Gemma. Omni Slash going. Maybe a black hole. It's going to get up to a couple who got it. Can't really cancel it. Mad's going to fall. Earthspike misses. Earthspike misses. Not that it matters. They kill everyone anyways. The only one that is a survivor is going to be this poor orange player sitting at 69 HP, limping back home. His Raptor's like, please get me the fuck out of here. Oh, my Lord. That is what you call a train wreck for Union Gaming. That ended.
That was a great fight for them, too. I mean, that hole was perfect. You got Midnight Pulse down. You got three heroes in it. And then Demon missed the Earth Spike. And then they all died anyway. Like, if that's what's happening after you get a good hole, then the game is not over. But it is nearing that point. The Fat Lady is warming up for her song.
Yeah, she's getting ready. And right now for Union Gaming, they're trying to get her off the stage, but it's really just
she's maybe like gargling with salt water, you know, making sure she's really ready for it. And when she's good and ready, then, you know, Summoner's Rift, I think they're just going to push into the base here.
Yeah, they're going
to go for tier 2. I mean, they're going to get a couple tier 2s off this, I think.
At least one. They should get at least
one. I feel like they should. They're being so careful, though. I mean, I guess when you have Banana Slam Jamma farming like this. Yeah, they have an Aegis. They should just push.
They really should. All their heroes are up.
I forgot it didn't die at all.
Banana Slam Jamma is so farmed. He could literally take all three of these on his own if he wanted to. That's not necessarily true, but that's what it feels like anyway. Z-Talk. Oh, slippery. That Enigma.
Union Gaming have to be so scared right now, too, because Jimmy got this Blink Dagger so early. Oh, Clockwork moving
Daddy?
In.
Zerker's call, maybe? Zeusalt's gonna go. They're fighting mid, I think. They actually got the tower. Axe is about to kill Greedy. Benha's finally taking him down. The Grave is up. Bugatti's gonna man up. Can they heal him back up to full? Midnight Pulse is finally gonna go. They do get Bugatti. Takes him forever to do so. Chasing after the Dazzle. Matt is probably going to fall here. And that's a big pickup for Benhaz. The double kill coming
up. They need to get him. They need to sandwich him. They're going to pincer him in.
Benhaz is like, I don't have Blade Fairy. Demon gets just the tip on the Earthspike. They get the kill. That was exceptional play. Brax with the assist on the double
double. Brax just kicks him right in the butt. Forces him right for it through that before that field gets up. And that's enough. Banana Slam Jamma. You get hit once by him and you are gonna die, basically. I mean,
yeah, Bash,
the Scotty between the Bash, Fervor Stacks, and Scotty.
Yeah, they'll find Greedy. Static Storm's gonna go. Banana Slam Jamma's like, I have an
Aegis.
I don't even really give a damn. Demon's like full health. Aegis is gone. Yule Scepter onto a hero with the TA. Demon backing up. Might get glimpsed. Actually, they don't have it. And they just destroy that disruptor. Banana Slam Jamma says, how are you? I'm gonna kill you within two hits. All right, cool. See you later. Demon is low. Huh. They're just gonna keep going.
Demon tanked a lot of tower hits. You know, he needs a little vacation to relax now, but Banana Slam Jamma doing all the heavy lifting at this point. And he is not afraid.
They do have black hole up in three. That's actually a map.
They can kill him if they catch him in a black hole, for sure. But Banana Slam Jamma needs to be a little bit careful here.
They have the entire team at his back though. They're ready to go now. I think they're gonna try to bait this.
Yeah, with fucking they get the full weave down. They're going in.
They're
going
to bait this. Oh, they have a satanic.
Oh, yes, what Jamma. The?
That's a 27-minute satanic.
How is he so far?
That's a 27-minute satanic. He's saying, let's go. Gets hooked up. Meanwhile, they're going to try to fight on this. Banana Slam Jamma actually just pops the satanic and goes to work. Graves gonna go. His Satanic now down, looking for Benhaz. He's gonna find him. The bash goes in place of Berserker's Call. Benhaz, goodbye, buddy. X up. Actually, Enigma died already. Has to buy back. It's X up again. They'll back away. They do lose Banana Slam Jamma. Bugatti's like, I can't do this alone. BKB now done for TA. That's not gonna save it from Berserker's Call, though. They are just, they are seconds Radiant's away from losing this Rax in the game.
A little bit of misplay there by Banana Slam Jamma. Used the Satanic too early. But, I mean, overall, that was a pretty good fight for them. I mean, they got a tier 3 tower. It's 28 minutes. They've got a 15k gold lead.
They have an
This is a do or die smoke right here.
If they lose even like one hero, no.
I mean, if this smoke gank goes bad, if this shows up on when smoke gank's gone wrong, you know, this game's just over.
It's
I think.
My favorite show. Yeah. I love that show.
That's on what channel would that be on? Animal Planet?
Dota Cinema.
Well, Z-Talk stunned up here. BKB done.
Ghost Scepter
is no fucks given.
He blinks out. That's how much of a man demon is. Rax is going to eels up in the air. He might die. He gets Grave. Bugatti jumps in, gets the call to one. Black Hole comes in. Demon going to try to cancel to the Earth. Oh, huge cook coming in from the clockwork. They only get one kill off of that Black Hole. They blow up the Enigma. Meanwhile, they do lose Mad Demon about to fall as well. But your two cores about to go to work. Two dead. How many more can they get? Kinetic Field? Well, I think that's it. That might
He has a Blink Dagger.
That's it.
Nope. Yeah, no call. Blink was up, but not going
to
do anything
I was
there.
Getting ready for them to kill the entire team, and then that Kinetic Field goes and...
They're like, ugh! It's like, what is that? When you run, you're running against like rubber bands or something. Do you ever use those?
What are you talking
about? Yeah, they got clotheslined by a field.
What the hell? Running into rubber bands? What's wrong with you?
I have this mental image in my head right now of what that was like, but I don't remember what it was. And I'll think of it, and I'll let you know.
You've lost it.
They're like, I can imagine them in my head, but I don't know what they're called or how to describe them. How do you feel about that?
Giant rope. I don't know. You should go back to hosting your talk show, dude.
Without you?
Yeah, without me, asshole. Dumbass Zoom program.
Program,
that is.
Banana Slam Jamma is 6-2 and 10 BKB for Axe. I think the minute that Banana Slam Jamma if he wants to get a BKB, I think it's could be acceptable, but he might just be happy to not
I don't think
do
he
that.
Needs it. Just love the Axe draw to work. And you just right-click from behind. He probably does more damage in his ranged form than Benhaz does ever in the game. That might not be true, but that's what it feels like right now. Based on attack speed and damage per second.
I mean, Benhaz almost has an Abyssal. At that point, that might not be true, but at the moment, he is.
It's arguable.
Not very much damage. They will find...
Okay, that's not necessary.
I mean, I think it's pretty good. Like, no disruptor ulti here. That means Banana Slam Jamma has no fear. Cast that Battle Trance, can cast the Whirling Axes, make sure they get the Mist Chance.
They're going in. They get the Melee Rack, that's it, I think.
Get out your pizzas, boys. Ripping pepperoni time. I don't know if they're gonna make it through this one.
Banana Slim Jamma at the front line, still Satanic. Hookshot onto two.
Oh,
the immediate
no!
X. Demon! What the heck? Greedy's gonna get blown up. TA getting chased down. Right now, Summoner's Rift actually just outplaying Union Gaming in this first game by far.
Well.
They're gonna go back in. Benhaz, it's been nice knowing you, buddy. We'll see you later. Double kill Bugatti. Throwing down the axe. Breaking it over the head of that poor Juggernaut.
Yeah, and they're just going to continue pushing on here. This is single limb, so Union Gaming will probably wait until the throne's actually dead. Do GG out. They've got two more chances at this one after this. Well, potentially only one more. But in a single limb situation like this, you want to make sure that, you know, they don't. Yeah, exactly. Like, the game actually ends. There's no reason to GG out early. You don't gain anything from it.
I mean, like effectively, if they lose top Rex, the game's effectively over. Two sets Rex, you can still theoretically come back from. I mean, it's possible. I don't think that'll happen, though. They're so far ahead. We'd have to see some throwy-ass shit. Maybe it starts here. Banana Slam Jamma gets thrown back into the ultimate of the Disruptor. They'll find out the TA. He gets Earth Spike. Demon doesn't have Finger for another second. Not that it would have killed him. Hookshot onto Mad. That will do something. God is like, I want a Berserker's Call. He'll do it. Counter Helix procs not there. Doesn't need them. doesn't even need the Calling Blade. He's just that. He's that good. Apparently, gets the mega kill streak, and they'll back up with, I guess, a kill that they probably didn't deserve, but they get anyway.
They're just running all over this game.
Banana Slim Jabba just heals up using lifesteal on the Ancients. He actually pops a Satan. I thought he might do that. I guess it's a 30-second cooldown. He just pops a Satanic, just goes to work on the Ancients. And that's just, I don't really got time for this shit.
You know what's amazing to me? That he says 320 CS despite being involved in 19 kills. That's really impressive.
This guy, I watched his stream, man. He's
I did not watch it, but I heard a lot of hype. Want a new informative stream?
You know, he was sitting. He was literally answering every question in chat, and he was just talking about, you know, his play and what he liked a lot, and his favorite players and things of that nature. He did say that RTZ was he thought the best player in the world currently, and I'm just like, don't say that, man.
Ever let him hear that.
Yeah, seriously, like that's just too much. It's gonna go to his head. I mean, we love Artur, but
I would never tell him that to his face.
Exactly.
Or at all, actually. TA needs to be a little bit careful here. Gonna be alright.
But they have a cheese for axe. Somebody bought something. Maybe I'm crazy. Did I miss it?
What?
Oh, that's a defusal blade coming out for the Juggernaut, huh?
Really?
What are you defusing?
I mean, I guess it purges off. Well, it purges off Shallow Grave, but.
And Ghost Scepter.
How? I mean, I guess that's alright. Is that really what's. I don't know if that's going to win
them
the fight.
That's not the choice, though. I don't think that's. I don't know. I guess
If they were ahead, I would say this is a good choice.
I think their only option at this point is killing the supports, though, because you can't kill the troll. I guess you can. He doesn't have a BKB yet. It's possible to kill him. It's not possible to kill the Axe, though, because he's a BKB and a cheese.
Yeah, I'm torn about this.
Dude, I'm going to be honest with you. I think this game is impossible for Union. I don't know.
It feels pretty uphill.
I don't know. If they come back, I'd be super impressed, but they seem so far behind. I mean, they're 20,000 net worth behind. It's not necessarily the numbers that are the crazy thing. It's more so just how far
I mean, I feel
is.
Like this game doesn't get better for them when it goes later. It's just like the major
thing.
Yeah,
exactly.
You know?
Like, I guess they have a TA, which
maybe
is pretty
TA
good.
Maybe TA is okay later, but it has an MKB to deal with the butterfly, but still just the raw HP on the troll is going to be an issue.
Yeah.
They have to have
the perfect fight, and honestly, this Disruptor, I think, might be the issue, because he's
also the Crimson Guard is pretty sick here.
When did they get that? They just got that for the Axe. That's
Axe just got it,
that's
yeah.
That's probably what I was thinking about in terms of the item. Banana Slam Jam, without any hesitation, bursts down that Tier 3 tower. This 6 seems down 2 sets of Rex at 35 minutes, 6.83, no comeback, so that's how you know. There's going to be the Zeus ult. They blow up that poor clock who's trying to fight from the side. It doesn't get a single pickoff. Doesn't have buyback either. Omnislash going into Bugatti doing literally nothing. Gets graved up early because why not? Banana Slam Shama still has Satanic pops it. Also has the Aegis Black Hole going on to 3. Braxton try to cancel, but there is that BKB. Ben Haas, they will get the one kill on the line. Buyback for Bugatti. He gets back into the fray. Juggernaut does have a buyback. He'll use it. Z-Talk will not be so lucky. He's going to get eulzed up. They'll chase him down. They'll destroy him. Ben Haas trying to do what he can. They've already lost all sets of Brax. It is Mega Creeps. Brax is getting right-clicked down by the TA. GG finally called, and that is that's it. Game, set, match here for this first game. Banana Slam Jam, they'll walk into the well. They'll have a party, and they will blow up almost every hero. And that is just maybe the best game of Dota that we'll see from X-Summoners or X-Fire. And that was impressive stuff, honestly. Just impressive stuff, Greg.
Yeah, I mean, I think the draft went really well for them. They destroyed every single lane, despite losing a bottle. That was a very good performance. I really chalk it up to both the Disruptor and a really good aggressive dual lane. I mean, beyond that, nothing else mattered that much. Clockwork did get donked pretty hard, it looks like, in the top lane up against the Troll, which is to be expected as well. And, yeah, I mean, mid was like okay, but they killed the bottle and Brax was still even, so that's not great.
Yeah.
Overall, just good performance by Fire, X Fire, whatever.
It was a good draft, first of all, and it was just solid lanes. And they were ahead in the laning phase when there was an Enigma on the enemy team without warding his jungle. That was the most impressive thing for me. So, Summoner's Rift just, I guess you could just say they outplayed Union Gaming in that game, that first game. So, a good start for a best of three series. Remember, this is single elimination. We'll have champions of Summoner's Rift taking the first victory here. It's a best of three series. Will they even it back up for Union? Or will they go down 2-0? We'll find out in this next game. Again, thank you so much for joining us here on Can of the Cup. My name is Mott. With me is Mott Pax. And, of course, WhatAssip. Check us out on Twitter, @MottPax, @WhatAssipTV, @MottDota. Check